Hello and welcome to 11 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. Their Royal Highnesses are currently visiting the kingdom upon the invitation of His Majesty the King. They conveyed the greetings of Queen Elizabeth II of the United Kingdom in Northern Ireland and her wishes for further progress and prosperity to Bahrain and its people. His Majesty welcomed His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and asked him to convey his greetings to Queen Elizabeth II and his wishes for her continued health and happiness. His Majesty then discussed the deep-rooted historic relations between the two countries and ways to further bolster these relations and achieve more progress in all fields in order to achieve the aspirations of both countries and their people. He also praised the strong ties between the two countries, which go back more than 200 years and are built on solid bases and mutual and shared interests. His Majesty the King then expressed his appreciation for the role of His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and his efforts in supporting bilateral relations and cooperation. He hailed the positive outcomes that resulted from the recent visit to the United Kingdom and his meeting with Queen Elizabeth II and the Prime Minister Theresa May. He said that the meeting will enhance the bilateral relations and achieve high levels of progress in all fields. His Majesty praised the role of the British community and their contributions in the progress of the kingdom in different fields. His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales then discussed ways to further develop the bilateral relations and joint action in order to serve the interests of both countries and their people. They also discussed regional and international issues. His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales expressed pleasure in visiting the kingdom and meeting with His Majesty the King, expressing his thanks and appreciation for the warm hosting as well as the generous reception. And he appreciated His Majesty's keenness in enhancing the bilateral relations. Later in the day, His Majesty the King hosted a dinner banquet today in Al-Rawda Palace in honor of His Royal Highness Prince of Wales and Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall. In the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa and Her Royal Highness wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa. The banquet was also attended by His Highness Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Sheikh Hamad bin Ibrahim bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, and Ambassador of Bahrain to the United Kingdom, Sheikh Fawaz bin Muhammad Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received at Ghalibiya Palace today the National Audit Office, the NAO President Hassan Al Jalahma, who presented His Royal Highness with the 13th NAO report for the fiscal year of 2015-2016. His Royal Highness commended the role of NAO's President and staff in assisting the government in maintaining public funds, highlighting the office's regulatory achievements, which are reflected in the high level of reports issued. The Prime Minister affirmed the government's keenness to implement strategies to control public funds, considering it one of the basic rights of citizens. The NAO President expressed pride in presenting His Royal Highness with the report in line with Article 19 of the office's law. He stressed that the NAO devotes all its efforts to develop monitored institutions, adding that the report's issues focuses on reviewing violations, their causes, and possible solutions to fix them. Jalahma urged the monitored institutions to implement the report's recommendations, stressing that such commitment will develop the performance of NAO. He affirmed that NAO will continue its cooperation with the executive authority to achieve their mutual aim, which is the best in the best interest of the country and its people. He also commended the cooperation between authorities and monitored institutions, which enabled NAO to carry out the task entrusted to it to maintain public money and to ensure the legality of using it. NAO's president thanked the executive authority's thanks support presented by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and his directives, adding that it honored him to listen to His Royal Highness's directives regarding the notes and recommendations included in the annual report. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa launched today a number of projects, including the development of Bahrain TV, the News Center, and the National Communications Center. That comes under the initiatives adopted by the government to develop the media of Bahrain and convey a message that it is up to date with recent international developments. His Royal Highness expressed pride in the kingdom's media and press and his confidence in their ability to protect the country, present the true reality of the kingdom to the world, and face the lies and rumors against Bahrain. These attacks aim to foil the national, political, democratic, and legal gains which have been achieved during the prosperous era of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness said that any technical or professional development in the media sector should contribute to strengthening the media message inside and outside Bahrain, especially under technological and information challenges. He stated that there are many attempts aiming to undermine the gains and achievements of the kingdom, but affirmed his confidence that the media of Bahrain is stronger than these attempts. Thanks to Bahraini writers and journalists who proved their firm stances during the unfortunate events that occurred in Bahrain. He called for all media sources to join efforts in order to serve Bahrain and its interests. His Royal Highness expressed hope that these developments will add a new media dimension inside and outside the country, directing Bahrain TV to interact with issues and concerns of the people of Bahrain. He expressed thanks and appreciation to the efforts exerted by the Information Minister, affirming his big aspirations in the fields of media, politics, economy, in addition to serving the society and meeting the needs of the citizens. His Royal Highness affirmed the need for a strong and continuous development media that is able to enhance the message in order to achieve the planned goals, clarify the facts, enlighten the public opinion, and face all attempts aiming to harm the freedom and progress of the kingdom. The Minister of Information Affairs, Ali Al-Rumahi, then delivered a speech on this occasion. He recalled the words of the late ruler of Bahrain, His Highness Sheikh Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, when he inaugurated the Radio Bahrain in 1955, affirming that the wise leadership has always been keen on developing the media in Bahrain. Al-Rumahi then briefed the audience on the media development plan under the directives of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister. He affirmed the completion of the development of all the technical devices used by adopting the highest modern technologies. He said that the ministry cooperated with 15 Bahraini companies during 6 months to implement a number of TV production projects. He added that the ministry depended on young Bahrainis in the preparation, presentation, and production process. Al-Rumahi said that 6 new studios were completed, including International Youth and Sports and the Holy Quran Studios. On the administrative level, 648 employees were placed on the new organizational structure. On the financial level, the approved budget was used without asking for exceptions. On the legislative level, a draft law on journalism and electronic media law was completed. A national communication center was established to manage international media, accommodating around 100 employees. The minister affirmed that under the order of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, a national training program to train 100 young employees to qualify them in the field, and it will start in January 2017, contracting with a specialized training company in the field of global media.
إذ بها تتحقق اليوم قيادة الشامية من الغاية التي تسعى إليها حكومتنا دائما. فعلى شعبنا العزيز أن يساهم مساهمة فعالة نحو هدفنا العظيم، ألا وهو إسعاد هذه البلاد والتقدم إلى الخير والسعادة. ستستمع للشعوب إلى ثمار جهودكم، وستحملون على الأثير اسم هذه البلاد العزيزة، فبذلك تكونون قد أديتم بعضا لهذه الوطن عليكم من واجبات. والسلام عليكم.
إن اهتمام القيادة بالإعلام والإعلاميين ليس بوليد السنوات الأخيرة التي اهتم بها العالم أجمع بالإعلام، فالصور التي أمامنا تؤكد زيارات ومتابعة شخصية تمتد لسنوات من الإنجازات لجميع القطاعات. صاحب السمو، أعلم أنا وجميع العاملين في هذا القطاع حجم المسؤولية الملقاة على عاتقنا، ونعلم جيداً أن المؤامرة والحرب الإعلامية التي تستهدف الوطن وتستهدف دول خليجنا العربي وعلى رأسها المملكة العربية السعودية الشقيقة مستمرة ولن تتوقف، ولكن يعلم الجميع أننا تعدينا مرحلة ردود الفعل وبدأنا مرحلة المبادرات التي تعكس قوة جبهتنا الداخلية. فالرسالة التي لم يعيها العالم الخارجي أن العلاقة بين شعوب الخليج وحكامها علاقة لم تفهمها مراكز الدراسات لديهم. في رقابنا للحكام بيعة، عزة النفس والكرامة لن نجدها إلا في أوطاننا. أما من باع وطنه والتجأ للغريب فلن يجد الكرامة. صاحب السمو، أستأذن سموكم بكلمة شكر أوجهها لأبنائكم منتسبي وزارة شؤون الإعلام، لكل المخلصين الأوفياء ممن يواصلون الليل بالنهار، يعملون بصمت هدفهم رفع راية البحرين، راية العز في خدمة وطنهم وفي أمر مليكهم عاهل البلاد المفدى الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة أيده الله، وتنفيذاً لسياسة حكومتكم الموقرة برئاسة سموكم حفظكم الله ورعاكم، ودعم سمو ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس الوزراء حفظه الله. اسمح لي يا صاحب السمو أن أستعرض أمام سموكم الكريم عدد من المشاريع التي تم تنفيذها خلال 6 شهور. هذه المشاريع تأتي في ضوء التحديات التي نواجهها، وبناء عليها رسمنا سياستنا الإعلامية التي تؤكد على هويتنا البحرينية والاعتزاز بعروبتنا وعلى وحدتنا صفاً واحداً مع أشقائنا في الدول الخليجية. فعلى هذه الثوابت الوطنية تم رسم خارطة التطوير الإعلامي. تم الانتهاء من تطوير كافة الأجهزة الفنية المستخدمة باعتماد أعلى التقنيات الحديثة. تم التعاون مع 15 شركة بحرينية خلال 6 شهور لتنفيذ عدد من المشاريع الخاصة بالإنتاج التلفزيوني. تم الاعتماد على الشباب البحريني في الإعداد والتقديم والعملية الإنتاجية كاملة. تم الانتهاء من بناء 6 استديوهات وبأحدث التقنيات. فلأول مرة استديو خاص للقناة الدولية، واستديو خاص للرياضة والشباب، واستديو خاص لقناة القرآن الكريم. إدارياً تم تسكين 648 موظف على الهيكل التنظيمي الجديد بعد 20 عاماً من آخر هيكل تنظيمي. مالياً تم الاعتماد على الموازنة المعتمدة دون طلب أي استثناء. تشريعياً تم الانتهاء من مشروع قانون الصحافة والإعلام الإلكتروني وإرساله للشركاء في الصحافة والمؤسسات الإعلامية قبل رفعه لمجلس الوزراء خلال الأيام القادمة لتمريره للمجلس التشريعي. الإعلام الخارجي، تم إنشاء مركز الاتصال الوطني، ولأول مرة يخصص مبنى متكامل لإدارة الإعلام الخارجي يستوعب 100 موظف. هذا ما تم بفضل من الله سبحانه وتعالى، ثم دعم سموكم الكريم حفظكم الله. وتنفيذاً لأمر سموكم الكريم بالاهتمام بالعنصر البشري البحريني، تم إعداد برنامج تدريب وطني لتدريب 100 شاب وشابة لتأهيلهم للدخول في صناعة الإعلام في يناير 2017، وذلك بالتعاقد مع إحدى الشركات العالمية المتخصصة في مجال التدريب الإعلامي، إضافة إلى إشراك القطاع الخاص للاستفادة من العنصر البشري البحريني المدرب. ختاماً، لا يسعني في هذا المقام إلا أن أشكر سموكم الكريم حفظكم الله على رعايتكم الكريمة، داعياً الله العلي القدير أن يمدكم بالصحة والعافية وأن يسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
نستقبل سموكم بعرض تقرير عن المشاريع التطويرية والبرامج التلفزيونية الجديدة.
تلفزيون البحرين، تلفزيون العائلة العربية.
مشاهدينا الكرام، أسعد الله مساءكم بكل خير، وإلى حضراتكم نشرة أنبائنا المصرية.
نحييكم من تلفزيون البحرين ونوافي حضراتكم بنشرة الأخبار لهذا المساء، أبدأها بالمقدمة.
حضرة صاحب السمو أمير البلاد المفدى يتلقى برقية
شكر. سيداتي يا نسات سادتي، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، وأسعد الله مساءكم وأهلا وسهلا بكم في برنامج جولة في عالم الصحافة.
التخطيط لتطوير الباقة البرامجية ومشاريع البنية التحتية لباقة قنوات تلفزيون البحرين. تم العمل على تجهيز 6 استديوهات جديدة: استديو البرامج الحوارية، استديو البرامج الشبابية، استديو البرامج الرياضية، استديو البرامج الدينية، استديو الأخبار العربية.
تابعونا في نشرة الأخبار يومياً على تلفزيون البحرين. تابعونا في النشرة الاقتصادية على تلفزيون البحرين.
استديو الأخبار الأجنبية.
Stay tuned for the latest local and international updates from the news desk at Bahrain International.
كما تضمنت الانطلاقة الجديدة باقة برامجية متنوعة.
في الحياة
برنامج الرأي.
وايد قصص وقضايا تمر علينا،
بس لا ننسى أحداثنا اليومية اللي لازم نوقف عندها وناخذ منها الزين ونخلي الشين.
وفي أشياء حلوة وفي تطلعات وآمال ومستقبل إحنا المسؤولين عنه.
وفصد زحمة الدنيا وأحداثها بحلوها وبمرها، يبقى كل واحد له رأي.
برنامج البحرين اليوم.
سرعة ودقة في نقل الأحداث الرياضية.
برنامج الملعب.
قوة وجرأة في طرح القضايا. نعيش قصص النجاح مع النجوم. ونقدم الموهبة التي يقودها الشغف نحو تحقيق أحلامها. فعندما تكون هنا فأنت في الملعب.
برنامج المختصر.
في هناك طبيب يتقصد الخطأ. الخطأ.
شوف، موضوع تنظيم القطاع الإعلامي هناك ثلاث نظريات. هناك من يؤمن بأن فضاء حر مفتوح يجب أن لا يخضع لأي قوانين.
ليس هناك جدل أو تشكيك في قدرة المواطن البحريني.
في مدينة عيسى كان عندنا مشكلة كبيرة قبل كم سنة، لما سووها على أساس أن فيها هلقة بيت وهل قد حجر نومتك البيت وسوى لها كم الطاقة اللي تحتاجها.
برنامج وطر مضى.
جينا بلاد عقيل والشيخ سلمان، زبن الطريد ومنطقة كل جاني، ربعي لهم شان وانا والعزاء شان، صبرا جميلا والله المستعان.
برنامج على رمال الخليج.
دليل حول ريادة بلادنا العزيزة البحرين في التعليم والتنوير على مستوى منطقة الخليج، صالح جاسم شهاب مهم وايد نركز على شخصيته ومسيرته. ليش؟
برنامج وقفات.
قال أوصيك أن تستحي من الله عز وجل كما تستحي من الرجل الصالح، وصية في غاية الروعة.
برنامج أبعاد.
الناس تتهمك بالطائفية، من المسؤول عن جعل رجال الدين مقدسين، الشعب أم السلطة؟
لا 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 لا، ما عندنا احنا مقدسين
عند الناس او عند
ما يعني... عندنا مقدسين، رجل دين حاله حال غيره.
برنامج الدار.
صلاح الزجالي شنو يتمنى؟
فنيا اني اخذ الجمهور.
هذا اكيد ميت فنيا.
برنامج رونج سايد.
فلسفي
غير ما يتفلسفون في السوشيال ميديا، جات علي انا. صح صح، اوكي اوكي، خلينا نتكلم.
برنامج بحرين توداي.
Stay tuned with us on Bahrain Today here on Bahrain International.
الاعتماد على الطاقات البحرينية الشابة في إعداد وتنفيذ البرامج التلفزيونية وتنفيذ المشاريع التطويرية، كما تم تنفيذ عدد من الفواصل التلفزيونية التي تعزز الهوية الوطنية.
يهديك من فيض المحبة تحية.
يتفضل وزير شؤون الإعلام بتقديم هدية تذكارية.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister pointed out that the experiences that Bahrain went through requires more awareness and to be up to date with all developments on the media level to make the voice of Bahrain heard and maintain its identity, stability and its national unity. He stressed that the Bahraini media message should present the news fast and on time of the event and that the Bahraini media should highlight all the achievements of the kingdom under the wise leadership of His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness admired the development projects in which it will take the Bahraini media to a new level through the use of modern technology and presenting a variety of programs that will attract more viewers. He stressed that the media message of Bahrain should promote peace, enhance the values of unity and cohesion, and to confirm the principles of Bahrain that enhances its identity and culture. His Royal Highness praised the advanced level of the media bodies in Bahrain, its technical development, and its use of young Bahraini cadres. He called to continue this march of development. His Royal Highness expressed pride and appreciation to the contributions of Bahrainis in developing the media of Bahrain, hailing the efforts of the Bahraini media in achieving progress in all fields. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister then received a cinematic camera as a commemorative gift manufactured by Freezy Flex Company, which covered outdoor events for TV programs and news from 1978 to 1983. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister then met with a number of media figures who greeted His Royal Highness and listened to his wise directives. His Royal Highness affirmed his respect and appreciation to them for their national efforts. He hailed the role in defending the kingdom against all attempts aiming to harm its security and stability. He affirmed his keenness to always read the ideas and valuable analysis they put forward. He added that his doors are always open and he would be glad to meet up with them and discuss matters related to the country and its people. His Royal Highness then greeted media figures and employees of the Ministry of Information Affairs. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received today His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall at Sakhir Air Base. The royal visit takes place following an invitation by His Majesty King Hamad. The Crown Prince asserted that Bahrain is proud of its long-standing relationship with the UK, noting that this year marks the 200th anniversary of bilateral relations. The Crown Prince also highlighted that throughout this time, both countries have witnessed significant bilateral development across economic, political, and cultural spheres. He emphasized that His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall visits highlights how important the collaborative relationship is between Bahrain and the UK. The Crown Prince concluded by noting that Bahrain is delighted that His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Cornwall have chosen to return to the kingdom, and extended his best wishes for a successful visit. Present were the sons of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The minister in attendance, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, and other senior officials.
Thank you.
His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander, First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa has visited today the Royal Guard. In the presence of Bahrain Defense Force BDF Commander-in-Chief, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. Upon arrival, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince was accompanied by his son, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman Al Khalifa, and was received by the Commander of the Royal Guard, Brigadier General Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and Royal Guard Special Force Commander Major Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince praised the efficiency and effectiveness of BDF affiliates in achieving goals, duties, and sacrifices in battlefields throughout their participation in the Arab coalition forces led by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to support legitimacy and restore hope in the Republic of Yemen that reflected the high level of combat readiness. His Royal Highness also noted the humanitarian and relief efforts in Yemen in which the BDF have participated in. The Crown Prince affirmed that these efforts are a source of pride and asked God to bless those who sacrificed their souls for their country and wished a speedy recovery for the wounded.
الواجب الخاص رقم 7 رياسة التفتيش سيد
After the national anthem, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince inspected the Guards of Honor.
أذنكم من طبور العرض سي Thank you.
The ceremony started with a recitation of verses from the Holy Quran. Then Commander of the Royal Guard, Brigadier General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, delivered a speech in which he welcomed His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, expressing pride in his visit. He added that the duty force 7 are privileged of his presence, saying that it is one of the forces that recently returned from the battlefields of Yemen after performing their duties in defending the country and supporting its elected legitimate government. His Highness commended the wise royal directives of His Majesty the King and his continuous support to all battalions, units, and military sectors in Bahrain's forces to develop its organization and training, as well as provide the latest weaponry to be fully prepared, as His Majesty wished it to be a shield for the kingdom and a support for the Gulf Cooperation Council, the GCC. His Highness stated that the BDF seeks to achieve the Crown Prince's vision and expectations in maintaining the advanced level of military proficiency and competence, and that reinforces capacity level in gaining and gaining experience and skills as a continuation of the development and modernization curriculum and deal with the challenges facing Gulf countries and the Arabic region. His Highness Sheikh Nasser also said that the Bahraini forces are providing relief work and provisions of humanitarian aid to the Yemeni people. He highlighted that the Royal Guard's work with the defense units in defending the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia's southern borders and supporting the government and the Yemeni people in fighting the rebels within the Arab coalition forces. The commander of the Royal Guard expressed that His Royal Highness's support for the BDF is in overcoming all difficulties, helped forces reach this exceptional military level. His Highness Sheikh Nasser also thanked the commander-in-chief for his constant support for all BDF affiliates.
وسنداً لأشقائنا في دول مجلس التعاون. سيدي، من هذا المنطلق نسعى في قوة الدفاع لتحقيق رؤى تطلعاتكم الثاقبة في أهمية المحافظة على المستوى، ليصبح أفرادنا وضباطنا ذو احترافية عالية لمواكبة متطلبات المرحلة والتعامل مع متغيرات العصر والتحديات التي تواجهها دولنا الخليجية وأقليمنا العربي. كما لا يسعني إلا وأن أذكر، بالإضافة إلى ما نقوم به من مهام، فإن قواتنا بالواجب تقوم كذلك بتقديم الأعمال الإيقافية وتقديم المعونات الإنسانية للشعب اليمني. سيدي، أيضا أود أن أشكر صاحب المعالي القائد العام لقوة دفاع البحرين لتذليل جميع الصعاب التي نواجهها، سواء في التحضير داخل المملكة أم في احتياجاتنا بداخل الأراضي اليمني الشقيق أم بالحدود الجنوبية للمملكة العربية السعودية. وهناك مقولة تنطبق على ما يقام به من عمل ومتابعة وإخلاص من سيدي معالي القائد العام، وهي العقلية الممتازة تتحدث عن المعركة، أما العقلية العظيمة تتحدث عن إدارتها وإدامتها. وفي الختام أدعو الله العزيز القدير أن يحفظ سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المفدى القائد الأعلى حفظه الله ورعاه سنداً ودخلاً للأمة العربية الإسلامية، وأن يديم عليه دوام الصحة ولباس العافية، وأن يحفظ مملكتنا ودولنا الخليجية من كل مكروه. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
After that, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince presented medals of appreciation to the officers and members of Special Operations of the Royal Guard in appreciation of their efforts of supporting legitimacy and restoring hope in Yemen. Thank you. PDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa received at his office at the headquarters today the Speaker of the National Assembly of Pakistan, Sardar Ayaz Sadiq, and his accompanying delegation, who are currently on a visit to the kingdom. Also present at the meeting were the Speaker of the Council of Representatives, Ahmed Al Mulla, the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Yusuf Al Jirahma, and PDF Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Diab Al Naimi. The PDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal praised the deep-rooted bilateral relations that continue to witness developments in various areas. The two parties also discuss issues of mutual interest.